Tony Lee. I'm with Nesson.com, the Boston Red Sox beat writer, as part of our new partnership with the YesNetwork.com. Here with Ken Singleton to ask a few questions about the Red Sox. Now, Ken, your experience.
Wait a minute, Tony. You said it's a partnership between the Red Sox and the Yankees at Nesson and Yes?
No, Nesson.com and
wow,
YesNetwork.com.
That's really crossing the line when it comes to these two teams. You understand what I mean?
I understand what you're saying.
This is new territory altogether. Now, I don't know how the fans are going to go for this in Boston or New York, but we'll do it. Let's do it.
I think they'll eat it up, actually, to be honest with you. The big talk in Boston has been the injuries.
Yeah.
One by one, this team has fallen 15 players on the DL. In your experience as a player and as an observer of this game, have you ever seen anything like this?
I've seen some teams have been decimated by injuries, but maybe not to the extent the Red Sox have been this year. A lot of all-star type players have been on the sidelines during the course of this year. And if they're not all-star type players, they're very good players. The Red Sox are a very good team, still a very dangerous team. I think Terry Francona, Tito's doing a great job with them. I think more than anything else, he has to keep a positive attitude about things and try to have the guys that are remaining, the remaining healthy players, think positively when they take the field each and every night.
Now, how difficult is that as a player when you see guys like Kevin Youkilis go down and, Theo Epstein yesterday called him the heart and soul of the Red Sox. How difficult is it for the healthy players to sort of say, all right, we got to take care of business today and press on?
First of all, I agree with Theo. Kevin Youkilis is one of the best players in this league, one of the best clutch hitters in this league. And the fact that he's going to be gone for the remainder of the season really puts a damper on the Red Sox offensively. Here's a guy who's going to score 100, driving 100, be a 300 hitter, and just do everything you would need somebody to do in the middle of your lineup. And for him to be out, that's really going to hurt them. It's going to be difficult. That is a big chasm to fill in your lineup. And I think that so many other guys, manager always say this, they're going to have to step up.
Now, there's been some sort of do-or-die talk in Boston related to this series, that the Red Sox need to at least get a split, but maybe win 3 of 4 or sweep. Do you see it that way, or do you think that they can kind of stay relevant in this race, even if they don't get out of here with a good result?
Well, I've seen teams come back in September from bigger deficits than the Red Sox have right now. A lot of things have to fall into place, that's true. But it would help them to win a few of these games here in New York for sure. But, you know, the Yankees are thinking differently about that.
And lastly, Ken, just for those people up in Boston who might be checking this out or here, can you compare this current Yankees unit to last year's championship team? Do they have what it takes to have a repeat performance?
I definitely think they can. I think, and people in Boston might not want to hear this, but I don't think the Yankees have played as well as they can. They've had certain players that haven't hit as well as they have in the past. Jeter and A-Rod for one. Some of the others, Swisher has come on a little bit. He's having a little better year. I think the bullpen's been a little shaky at times. Jabba hasn't been what they expected from time to time. Mariano's been awesome once again. So if they can get the ball to him, the other guys can carry the water to him. Usually the Yankees are going to get a drink out of it. So the fact is, if they can get Mariano the ball, they're going to win. And that's one thing Red Sox fans are going to have to. If that happens during the course of the remainder of the year, the Yankees are going to win.
All right. Thanks a lot, Ken. I appreciate it.